For the first time, a spacecraft has touched the sun. The NASA spacecraft Parker Solar Probe spent more than 3 years winding its way through planets and progressively approaching our star to learn more about the origin of the solar wind, which propels charged particles across the solar system. The new achievement is a huge step forward for the Parker Solar Probe and a giant leap forward for solar science. Just like landing on the moon helped scientists understand how it was formed, touching the very stuff the sun is made of will help scientists unearth crucial facts about our closest star and its influence on the solar system. Parker Solar Probe was launched in 2018 with the goal of exploring the mysteries of the sun by traveling closer to it than any previous spacecraft. The probe has finally arrived, 3 years after launch and decades after its conception. Observations from Parker's April 28th flyby, which was the eighth time the spacecraft whizzed by the sun, revealed that the spacecraft managed to reach inside the sun's atmosphere, or corona, for the first time. The sun, unlike our Earth, is not a solid sphere, but it does have a zone where the star's immense gravity keeps in the solar material and spews through fusion. However, at a certain distance from the sun, gravity and magnetic fields are too weak to hold that material together. It's from that point, known as the Alfvén critical surface, where the solar wind flows away from the sun, never to return. Solar material with enough energy to pass that point becomes the solar wind, which carries the sun's magnetic field with it as it speeds through the solar system to Earth and beyond. Significantly, the solar wind moves so fast beyond the Alfvén critical surface that waves within the wind can never travel fast enough to return to the sun, serving their connection. Previously, faraway images of the corona revealed that the Alfvén critical surface was between 4.3 and 8.6 million miles, that would be 6.9 to 13.8 million kilometers from the sun's surface, which is equivalent to 10 to 20 times the radius of the sun. These estimates were not too far off. According to Parker's data, it crossed the Alfvén critical surface on April 28th at 18.8 solar radii, 8.1 million miles above the sun's surface, and finally crossed the solar atmosphere. Parker Solar Probe flew into and out of the corona many times during the flyby. It discovered that the Alfvén critical surface is not shaped like a smooth ball. It has spikes and valleys, as NASA termed it, where the surface protrudes higher or lower from the sun's center. The surface also likely varies with solar wind activity, which is dependent on the sun's 11-year solar cycle. Parker was only able to spend a few hours in the corona due to the intense conditions, but it did manage to go as low as 15 solar radii, around 6.5 million miles from the sun's surface. In that zone, it found a pseudostrema, one of the huge structures that rise above the sun's surface and can be seen from Earth during total solar eclipses. Passing through the pseudostrema was like flying into the eye of a storm. Inside the pseudostrema, the conditions quieted, particles slowed, and the number of switchbacks decreased. This is a stark contrast to the bustling barrage of particles the spacecraft ordinarily faces in the solar wind. Parker is expected to get considerably closer to the sun in future flybys, coming as low as 8.86 solar radii, 3.83 million miles from the sun's photosphere, its visible surface. Some surprising physics surfaced even before the first trips into the corona. During recent solar encounters, Parker Solar Probe collected data on the source of zigzag-shaped structures in the solar wind known as switchbacks. The data showed one spot that switchbacks originate is at the visible surface of the sun, the photosphere. The switchbacks have been known for a long time, but they were initially identified in the 1990s by the NASA European Space Agency mission Ulysses, which orbited the sun's poles. While scientists first thought the switchbacks were only found in solar areas, Parker discovered in 2019 that they were common in the solar wind. According to new discoveries by the mission, switchbacks occur in patches and have a higher percentage of helium, known to come from the photosphere, than other elements. Scientists also found that the patches line up with magnetic funnels emerging from the photosphere, called supergranules. This is useful for understanding solar physics, because the funnels may be where fast solar wind particles originate. The structure of the switchback regions corresponds to a small magnetic funnel structure at the base of the corona. Some theories predict this, and this identifies a source for the solar wind itself. If scientists could better understand the physics of switchbacks, they may be able to explain why the corona is millions of degrees Fahrenheit or Celsius hotter than the Sun's surface. The next solar flyby for the Parker Solar Probe is set for late February 2022, though the spacecraft will collect data for weeks before and after the closest approach. The touching of the Sun by the Parker Solar Probe is a watershed moment in solar science, and indeed an extraordinary achievement. Not only does this achievement give scientists a better understanding of the Sun's evolution and its effects on the solar system, but everything they learn about the Sun also educates them about other stars throughout the universe. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.